In this video, I'll show you guys how to graph y is equal to sine x, and we also do y is equal to cosine x. And this is just going to be a quick version of common vector graphs for sine and cosine. And you have to first know that sine and cosine, they both look like this, right? They are like waves, and they are called the periodic functions. And I'll show you guys what we need to graph one period for both of the sine and cosine. All right, so first of all, I will show you guys by making a table. We will have some x value for the input, and we know y will be sine of whatever this x that you choose to be, right? And we will select a few x values right here. And let me tell you what are the x values that we're going to use. And when we're doing sine and cosine, the best thing to do is let's look at unit circle, but you don't have to memorize the whole points on the unit circles. We just have to know the four important ones. You don't have to memorize everything, but four important ones. So let me just draw the unit circle right here for you guys, like this. The four points are going to be this one, this one, this one, and this one. Because these four points right here are going to tell you the highest, the lowest, and also the x-intercept for sine and cosine graphs. All right, first of all, you see right here on the unit circle-wise, we're talking about this being the 0 degree, and also it's the same as the 0 radians. Right here is the 90 degree, and the same as pi over 2. For we're doing graphs, always radians, no degrees, all right? So when you go this way, we know it's 180 degrees, but this is the same as pi radians, and here it will be 3 pi over 2, namely 270 degrees. And at the end, we'll do one revolution, so we'll come back to 2 pi, and so on, so on, so on, right? It's just like you run around a circle. So as you can see, I'm just going to select x to be 0. The x right here is the input. So the 0 is the angle, right? That's the input. 0 radians. And I want to just run one revolution, so I'll end up with 2 pi. So we have the 2 pi right here. So anyways, this explains why the period of a sine function is 2 pi. Okay? Just sine of 1x. The period for that will be just 2 pi. One revolution. Because the next loop is going to be pretty much the same as the first loop, right? Right now, this will be my next input, which is the pi over 2, and then pi, and then this one is the 3 pi over 2. Okay, so this is how we're going to choose the x value. This is how we're going to choose the input to plug into the sine function. Okay, right here we have these four points. You have to remember the coordinate of the points. This right here is 1, 0. This right here is 0, 1. This right here is negative 1, 0. And this right here is 0, negative 1. These are the four points you have to remember on the unit circle. The rest, you can do it by using the reference triangle. But you know, these four are the ones that you have to know really, really well. And the other thing you have to know is, for the sine, you have to know that it is the y values on the unit circle. So when you have the input to be 0, I know this is x, but when you're talking about graph, it's usually just x and y. And we'll come up with a graph, you know, x-axis and the y-axis. But this 0 is the input. Sine of 0, you look at the unit circle and look for the y value. This is going to be sine of 0, which is going to be 0, all right? So we have 0, 0 first. And then you run around a circle. Next, you will go here, sine of pi over 2. You look at the y value, which is going to be 1, all right? And then you just continue running around a circle. Next one will be 0. And next one is going to be negative 1. And when we come back, we once again get back to 0, like that. These four points are going to tell you the maximum, or maybe the 0, and the minimum for sine and cosine. So this is pretty much what we need. And just to remember, once we connect the dots, you have to have a wave, that's all. And let me just kind of draw this real quick for you guys right here. So suppose I have, this is my 1, this is my negative 1, and we have, this is my 0 degree, well, 0 radians technically, and let me say this is my pi over 2, which is the same as 90 degrees, and this is pi, this is my 3 pi over 2, and then this is my 2 pi. Plug points then. First, we have 0, 0, which is right here. And then it goes up to pi over 2, comma 1, which is right here. And then pi, comma 0, which is right here. And this, comma negative 1, which is down here. Lastly, we get back to 0, like that. At the end, just connect the dots with a nice curve, like this. And that's one period of the sine function. And of course, you know, if you want to continue beforehand, you can just do like that, right? And then if you want to continue after this, you just go like this. Anyways, here is the sine function right here, y is equal to sine x. And I will make more videos later on for you guys. What if we have more things inside of the sine? Maybe we will also have a few things like outside of the sine, but that's later on. Right, next, let's talk about cosine. Once again, I will pretty much set a table for you guys. We have the x and also the y value. This is y is equal to cosine x. And we have these 5 points, right? 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. This time, we'll be looking for the x value for cosine. This right here is the cosine. So first, we will have 1. 0, right? If you plug in 0 into cosine, you get 1. Next, you get 0. Cosine of pi over 2 is 0. And then continue, negative 1. Okay, cosine of pi is negative 1. And you get 0 right here. Right? And then at the end, you get back to 1. Right? Once again, running around a circle, and for cosine, you look at the x values on the unit circle. All right, so now I'll just kind of pretty much do the same thing for you guys, make a graph right here real quick. And I will label this is my negative 1, pretty much the same like that, right? And this is my 1. 0, pi over 2, right? And then pi, and then 3 pi over 2, and then here is my 2 pi. Okay, this time we have 0, 1, so cosine function starts right here. And we have pi over 2, 0. And we have pi, comma, negative 1. And we have 3 pi over 2, comma, 0. And then 2 pi, comma, 1. So it's like this. So now I'll connect the dots with a wave like this. Okay? So as you can see, it takes 2 pi to go from the highest to the next highest. All right? So anyways, here we have it, the graph of sine x and the graph of cosine x. That's it.